Hi there, fellow beauty finders. It's Matthias Allen, otherwise known as Matthias for Makeup on all social media, and I'm so excited to be sharing with you a first impressions video this week. Every week on my First Impressions Friday series, I show you exactly what I think about brand new products. So if you want to see what I'm wearing on my skin, please look down below in the description for links to the video, which will explain exactly what I have on. So for those of you who have been following me here on my YouTube channel for months or even years, you know that Urban Decay is one of my favorite brands. They have been a PR supporter of mine for many, many, many years. I absolutely love pretty much everything that they send me. And in this First Impressions Friday video, I'm going to be sharing with you a brand new collection from them. So the Urban Decay Backtalk Eye and Face Palette just came out, and I recently got sent it, and I've been really excited about trying this out for myself. So I'm going to show you exactly what it looks like when you open it up. And now at first when I opened it up, I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. There's a mirror inside and it kind of looks like that. And then I was like, oh, the mirror came out, it broke. And then I realized, no, it's magnetic, which is really kind of cool because then you can take this mirror with you and you can put it in your purse. And as long as you maybe wrap it in bubble wrap or tissue. But anyway, be careful. Don't drop your purse on the floor if you have this in your purse. Like that, see? I want to say that this definitely has more of a cool undertone vibe. This has, it does have a peachy gold right here, but the majority of the colors are more in the wine shades, if you will. So the kind of like violets, lilacs, more winey inspired. So I'm going to try a couple of these blushes and highlights on for you, and I'm going to show you what they do to my skin and give you my first impressions. I'm even going to throw on a couple of the eye colors as well and give you an idea of what I think of the pigment and what I think of the products themselves. Next, I'm going to be applying some of the brand new Sigma Cosmetics eyeshadow base primers. Now, I have these in three different colors. I have them in Persuade, Sorbet, and Bubbly. I'm going to start with Persuade, which is the lightest of the three. Now, I'm going to go in with the Sigma eyeshadow base primer in Sorbet. Bubbly is more of a shimmer color, and so I would say that the shimmer then, of course, okay, yeah. Shimmer, if you want, you know, something more shimmery, definitely use Bubbly or get Bubbly. This is really pretty on the lid, just for a little bit of sheen and sparkle. And I've used the Sigma Wide Shader E59 brush to buff that out onto the lid. Now I'm using the Glow Minerals Water Resistant Mascara. So next I'm going to be using some of the Urban Decay Backtalk Eye and Cheek Palette for you. I'm going to start with the, let's see, which one? This is Cheap Shot, which is very, very, very deeply wine with a lilac undertone. I'm probably not going to do that. That's not my favorite kind of a shade. I think Double Take would be really pretty in kind of the contour of my cheek, and then maybe a little bit of low-key or Party Foul up high to highlight. So I'm going to start with Double Take, and I'm going to be using the Sigma Duo Fiber Powder Blush F15. Okay, so I'm just going to take a little tiny bit of this onto my brush, not digging into the product, I'm just literally tapping because I don't want to pack up the brush in case the pigment is very, very, very strong. Now the palette actually comes with a little mirror, which is nice, so you can kind of see what you're doing. I'm going to get a little more on the brush. There you go. Okay, so there's the pigment. Yes, 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 come through. Pretty, pretty, pretty. It's nice. It's a good color blush. Okay, so I think the tone looks really pretty on my skin, especially with the Sigma eyeshadow bases that I used earlier. Let's see what the highlighter does on my skin. So I'm going to use a little bit of Party Foul. This is the lighter of the two highlighters, so I'm going to swipe that right here, and I'm going to use the Sigma High Cheekbone Highlighter F03 brush. I'm going to pop that right there on the high point of my cheekbone. Same thing. I'm going to do a little bit more on this side. Wow. Now the highlighter is gorgeous. I mean, that is a lot of shine. Now on the other side, I'm going to use a little bit of Low Key. So Low Key has a touch more pinky champagne with a little bit of a peach. I'm going to try this on the other side right here. Now that one looks even more natural, I think, on my skin because I'm more of a medium skin tone, but it's nice to have the option of the two. What do you guys think down below? As far as the consistency and the color and the saturation, I think it's really, really, really pretty. It didn't go on patchy at all. It went on super smooth. I think definitely the lighter of the two is great for lighter skin tones, and the one that's more peachy gold is gorgeous on more of a medium tone like me. Okay, so now I want to play with some of the eye colors. I'm not going to go too dramatic. I just want to kind of see some of the pigment. So I'm going to start with Three Sheets, which is the lightest of the entire palette. I'm packing the brush on both sides, and then I am going to highlight under my brow bone with that, just like this. I feel like I have to pick more up just to see it. And it's there, but it's not, it's a subtle highlight. It's not too strong. And now in my mid-range crease, I'm going to be taking the WTF, yes, I said WTF, color, and I'm going to be taking that on a Sigma Diffused Crease E38 brush. Oh, hello, pigment. That is, yeah, that's rich. That is really rich. Okay, same thing, other side. I only really needed to swipe like three times to get this much color, so this is nice. Okay, so I'm working that into the outer corner and then bringing that into my orbital bone. Wow, that's a really pretty color. It's kind of like a really dark cinnamon. So I like the warmth in that a lot. Okay, so next I'm going to take the, let's see which color. I'm going to take a little bit of the Curve, which is a what looks like a lilac silver with a slight purple undertone. And I'm going to pop that on the lid. Ooh, that's pretty. Okay. Same thing, other side. Absolutely zero fallout. I just want to point that out right now. I'm looking at my eye and there's like nothing on my cheekbone that's fallen. So that is a really, really good thing to see. Now I want the colors to diffuse out a little bit. I don't want it to be as strong in my crease. So I'm going to take the Sigma Tapered Highlighter F35 brush and I'm going to swipe back and forth and just try and diffuse out that crease with this larger highlighter brush. I love being able to do this with a highlighter brush that has a point. Do you see that kind of like point in the center? That's great because that fits right into my eye socket. Okay, and then lastly, I'm just going to define out just the lash line just a tiny little bit. And I'm going to be using the eye shading E55 brush from Sigma. And I'm going to go in with the color Shade. And I'm going to mix that with 180. See those two colors together? Pretty, right? I love how that looks. That was a really good decision. Okay, I'm gonna go back in with Shade and 180. And then with the Sigma Diffused Crease Brush E38, the one that I did that deep cinnamon color called WTF, I'm gonna go ahead and just softly blend those like so. And I'm telling you guys, like, no fallout. Like, it is so, so good how well these stuck to my skin. Oh my God, that's nice. I really hope you enjoyed this week's first impressions video. If you have any comments or questions about these particular products, if you've used them before and you've liked them or disliked them, I want to hear from you. I want you to be interactive, so please do leave me a comment down below. If you want to get your hands on any of these products, please consider using my affiliate codes, which are also listed down below in the description section. I give you links to Amazon, Ulta, Sephora, so many different retailers, and I would love for you to use use them if you'd like to purchase online. Thank you so much for following me here on my YouTube channel every single week. I love you, love you, love you. Please continue to stay with me here and check out one of my other two videos that I've produced for you with another glam tutorial. Thank you so much, and I will see you next time. Bye for now.